Hurricanes are in Florida this afternoon and are looking for a win against Tampa Bay here on FSN. And our California University bench interview is Chris Letang. And Chris, you'll probably see a lot of Steven Stamkos this afternoon. How do you slow down a guy that has scored a lot of points as of late?
You make sure you maintain a good gap. You take his time and space away, and you make sure he doesn't have too much time to shoot because he's got a great shot.
All right, Chris, thanks for the time. Good luck.
Starts the game here for the Penguins against Tampa Bay. That's the kind of stuff that Dan Bylsma does. So look out, here's Stamkos shooting, and a save made by Fleury off his left arm.
And an Orpik absolutely hammered Stamkos, who's just been ringing up the shots in the last few hockey games.
Letang wheeling into the net, and he goes in behind the goal.
Crosby's
now he's hit, and Sid is injured. He's down.
Yeah, here goes Kennedy, getting right into it. Is that Downey he's behind the net with? I had a feeling that Kennedy would get in a fight in his first shift. That's something Tyler Kennedy always likes to get going. He took a shot earlier in the shift, but then I'm not sure who it was that, or even what happened, until I see it exactly what happened to Sidney Crosby, who's been injured in the first. But let's take a look here and take a look and see if it was yeah, there's Downey. He's got the knee behind the leg of Sidney Crosby. He took him right out.
That's one of the dirtier plays we've seen against Sid in his career.
Wow. And we talk about attempting to injure a player, and that is something right there with a player almost put him in like a figure four lock stagger with the knee behind Sidney Crosby's knee, and it looked like he tried to snap his leg.
It's a version of a slew foot, I would say. Not so much the boot of the skate using that as the whole leg.
Look at this. Look at this. The knee's behind Sidney Crosby.
Oh, boy.
No.
I
can't even look at it.
I don't even know if I want to see that one again.
And the Penguins and the Lightning are scoreless after one period of play, and our Suzuki player interview is Mike Rupp, who is looking for his 13th goal of the season, but that pesky post just had a step in front of it, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a great play by Adzi, kind of baiting in their forward to move out and left me open and just throwing it on net and hit the post. So we're going to keep firing it, and hopefully we'll get a bounce and hit the post and go in.
Tonight's lineup, at least to start the game, and for most of that first period, had you and Adams and Tyler Kennedy on one line. What kind of difference does it make for you to have TK on that line, and what does he bring to that line?
Well, TK's a guy that's just going to dog the puck all over the ice, and that's what we want. I love the way he gets in there, and he never gives up on the puck. And when he's got the puck in the corner, I know that he's going to handle it, and we're going to have some good zone time. So, you know, that's what I think we did that period, and we're going to look to build off it.
All right, Mike, thanks for the time.
All right, thanks, Zach.
Well, Adams is going to time his hit with perfection. The puck just touched by Lundin. Lundin, the man who is supposed to be in charge of covering Sidney Crosby.
Here's Victor Hedman with it now. Feeds it to the corner. Fedorik in after it. Centers, quick shot, they score! Vincent LeCavalier buries one behind Marc-Andre Fleury. Nothing went on the outside of the post. Now McKee down the wall for Fedotenko to the corner for Mike Rupp. Ponikarowski after the puck behind the net. He centers one. And Fedotenko went to the goal. Rupp is down. He went down in a heap. He got his legs for a guy his size you'll ever see. A lot of power in those legs. Now here's Gonchar, centers, Stahl with a shot off a leg wide of the goal.
Purcell.
Stick on the ice.
He shot that stick at the puck. It's interference. He's going to go off the ice. Purcell, not knowing the rules of the game. It was an errant stick on the ice. He shot that stick right at the puck. And he's going
to Gonchar. Gonchar to Sid. Letang's open. One-timer. Now to Sid. A shot. Great save by Ninomagi with a right pass. Puck loose. Did he win the goal? Boy, it was right on the goal line. Malkin's got it now as time runs out. Boy, I thought that puck was right on the goal line there.
I think it was. You could see everybody look behind as it was dancing around on a string, but it would not go over that goal line. The puck came in. Sidney Crosby, there's the initial shot. There it is. It's slipping in there on the goal line. The Lightning find a way to keep it out.
Welcome back to Tampa, Florida, where the Lightning have a 1-0 lead over the Pittsburgh Penguins. And our Chevy player interview is Ruslan Fedotenko. And in watching the first two periods, do you get the impression that Tampa is using that neutral zone trap a little bit more than you had expected? Or are they just playing extremely good defense in that neutral zone?
No, they're playing really well. They were really well. They have high intensity, they defend the checks, and I feel like we just need to pick it up a little bit. I feel like our passing is not as accurate. I feel like we just need to get the intensity up and just play physical a little bit and just play our game.
Dumping the puck a little bit more in the zone can help as well?
Yeah, I feel like we just need to hold on to the puck offensively. I feel like we didn't spend enough time creating offensive chances and grinding them down there. I feel like it's usually they come out really easy and you know, then take you know, 3-2 and 3-3, and you know, the D's joined them. So I feel like we just need to play a little bit better.
All right, Ruslan, thanks for the time.
Thank you.
Around 10 o'clock, so they came in really early to get some work done. Their work is never done. Brooks Orpik with a shot. And turning and shooting and stall. Allen in the back, he got a piece of that. Dupuy gets the rebound off the boards and scores. The Penguins have tied it as Pascal Dupuy pounced on a lucky bounce. Finally, they get one. And they take advantage of it to tie it at one.
Well, they got some muckers and grinders. Ninamäki had the puck in behind the net. And the Penguins, they get on the forecheck. They turn the puck over on the wall. Orpik gets it to the net. Stahl misses that whack. Cook had a chance. He was shut off, but Pascal Dupuy followed up. Secondary chances. Isn't that what we're talking about? Here's a secondary chance as the puck came to the front of the net. Pascal Dupuy finished the play.
He's replaced by St. Louis, who will kill the penalty with Thompson up top. And Lundin and Mazaros are back. It's Gonchar. Head up. Fire. Score! Oh, did he rifle that puck off the post and into the goal? And a power play goal has given the Penguins the lead.
I tell you, the power play looks really good right now, doesn't it? And it's not a slight to Evgeny Malkin. It's just that they know what they want to do. And they have something in mind. Look at the forecheck by Ponikoroski. Shuffles it loose. Crosby goes low to high. And there's the rip shot. And Ponikoroski went right to the front of the net. After he made the play, he went to the front of the net. He lifted his left skate in the screen. It was all Ponikoroski. Look at the forecheck. He takes on two men. Gets it to Crosby. Back to Malkin. No hesitation. Gonchar, excuse me, rips it.
With ice, with points. We've seen him go to the net.
Here's a chance for the Penguins. A two-on-one. Rupp and Crosby. Rupp closes into Crosby. Ninamäki came across and somehow prevented that shot from cleanly getting to go. Net. Lecavalier sets it up. Tried to go back to Purcell. The bouncing puck. Foster with it. 5 seconds to go. Stamkos takes it to the net. Blocked by Eaton, who put his body down. Purcell centers. Where's the puck? It's behind the net as time expires. And the Penguins ward off what looked like a power play at the end of the game with the extra attacker on for the Lightning. And with the two players in the penalty box, the Lightning could not get the puck behind Fleury, and the Pittsburgh Penguins defeat the Lightning here in a come-from-behind win, 2-1.
Now, Pascal Dupuy broke the ice for the Penguins here. McDonald's player of the game. But Pittsburgh, they got mean. They got fierce. Fedotenko dropped the mitts when he had to. The Penguins crashed and banged. They got the puck behind Ninamäki.